हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आर टॉपिक एज पोस्ट फर्टिलाइजेशन इवेंट्स। इट कंप्राइजेज ऑफ ऑल दोज इवेंट्स विच आकर आफ्टर द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्टिलाइजेशन, दैट इज आफ्टर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द जाइगोट। व्हाट हैपन्स इन दिस? इन दिस इफ द प्लांट अंडरगो डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन, मीन्स one of the male gamete it mates with the ovule and other it mates with the endosperm. So after those, the formation of the seed and the formation of the fruit and conversion of the fruit into an embryo and ultimately other kind of growth, all these events comprises of post fertilization events. In those, first one is the formation of the embryo. So first of all, what is embryo? So embryo is nothing, it is formed when the fertilization of the primary endosperm nuclei occurs with the male gamete, and the formed tissue is said to be the endosperm tissue. It is the triploid tissue which provide nourishment to the growing or the developing embryo. So what about the endosperm? It is not of that kind that it doesn't divide and nothing like that. It first divides via division of nucleus, and followed by nuclear division, the cytoplasmic division takes place. As it is, the PN undergoes successive nuclear division in which the free nuclei are formed. After this, around each nuclei, the cytoplasm or the cell wall formation deposition occurs. It is said to be the formation of a cellular type of the endosperm. So first division is nuclear and second is cellular. After this, a complete endospermic tissue or the type of endosperm, free nuclear endosperm, formed. ठीक है, वट इज अबाउट एंडोस्पर्म? नॉट ओनली इट इज नॉट द टाइप ऑफ टिश्यू विच इज ऑलवेज सेलुलर, इट इज नॉट द टाइप ऑफ टिश्यू विच इज ऑलवेज न्यूक्लियर। बोथ काइंड ऑफ टिश्यूज आर प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फ्रूट्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इन कॉकोनेट देर इज प्रेजेंट फ्री न्यूक्लियर टाइप ऑफ एंडोस्पर्म विच इज फॉर्म्ड ऑफ थाउजेंड्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियाई इन ईच, मतलब इन अ सिंगल सेल थाउजेंड ऑफ न्यूक्लियाई आर प्रेजेंट। As you know, embryo is the nourishing tissue. So as the seed or the embryo, it grows, it utilizes all the nutrients provided by the endosperm. So endosperm may either completely or partially it get consumed by the developing embryo when the seed undergo maturation, or it may persist. On that basis, seeds are of two type. They are said to be the endospermic type of seeds or the non-endospermic type of seeds. If the seed have endosperm as a nourishment tissue, the seeds are said to be the endospermic type of seed. If the all the endosperm get utilized or consumed during seed maturation and the nourishment tissue at that stage is present in the form of cotyledons, that kind of state is said to be the extra-albuminous type of seeds. So number of seeds are given here, you can make them memorize by name. Next point is about the embryo, how the formation of the embryo takes place. So the formation of embryo is called as embryogeny. So what is embryogeny? It comprises of all the stages, all those stages which are expressed by embryo during its period of development. So embryogeny is the conversion of the zygote into a complex type of embryo. In this process, number of divisions takes place, and it is not in the case as in secondary and primary growth that primary growth is different, secondary is different. In monocots only primary growth takes place, and in dicots the secondary growth occurs. It is not like that. In both monocotyledons and dicotyledon type of plant, embryogeny is almost similar, but in the diagram shown here, it is the type of endospermy which is shown by the diploid or the dicotyledonous type of seeds. As you know, in dicotyledonous seeds, at the one end eggs are present which are surrounded by synergids, then it is polar nuclei, and on other side antipodal cells are formed. When the fertilization takes place, the synergids disappear and the antipodal cells, they start to degenerate. With this, what is le- we are what we are left with? We are left with the zygote and the endospermic type of nuclei. That division first undergo the cellular division. It results in formation of two cells. After this, some kind of structures are formed, followed by number of divisions. ठीक है, दिस इज फर्स्ट इज सेड टू बी द ग्लोबुलर टाइप ऑफ एम्ब्रियो एंड अदर इज फॉर्म्ड विद द हार्ट शेप्ड एम्ब्रियो दैट आर द करेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ द डिप्लॉयड और द डाइकोट टाइप ऑफ द सीड्स. नेक्स्ट, अल्टीमेटली द फॉर्म्ड स्ट्रक्चर दैट रिजल्ट आफ्टर द फॉर्मेशन और द नंबर ऑफ डिवीजन अंडरगोन बाय द प्राइमरी एंडोस्पर्म न्यूक्लियाई, इट रिजल्ट इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस दैट इज रेडिकल फ्रॉम विच द रूट विल डेवलप and the other point at is it is plumule from which plumule from plumule the shoot will arise and there are two cotyledons which are for providing nourishment to the growing seed and this is the diagram of a mature type of an embryo which is formed after undergoing complete steps or sequences of the embryogeny. Next is, as is shown in this diagram, this is the diagram which shows the typical dicot embryo. It means it is the embryo of a dicot type of plant, means dicot seeds are those which have two cotyledons to store the nourishing type of tissue. So as the name implies, it comprises of two cotyledons. At the tip or the start of this cotyledons, plumule is present, and at the other end the radical is present, and you are very familiar with this. From the plumule the shoot will form, and from the radical the root will form. Both the plumule and radical are necessary for the germination of the seed. Next point is the presence of apicotyle and the hypocotyle. So what is apicotyle? Apicotyle is the region which is present between the plumule and the cotyledons, means the upper area, and the area which is present between the cotyledons and the reticle, that is said to the apicotyle. So api means upper, hypo means lower. Api is present near the plumule side and hypocotyle is present near the radical side. Next is, this is very complex type of embryo, but it is present only in the grasses. Where it is present? It is present in the grasses only, means in monocotyledon type of plant. The characteristic feature of this type of embryo is the presence of the scutellum. The scutellum is present only in the grass family, where the cotyledons are a kind of modification, where the cotyledons undergo some kind of modification and it develop as a scutellum. Okay, next, at the embryo axis on lateral side, the presence is there is presence of scutellum. Then the two parts which are not present in upper embryo, that are colluptile and the colluriza. As you are very familiar with the plumule and the radical, so the type of leaf which covers the radical area or the root cap area, that is said to be the colluriza. And the leaf which cover the shoot or the plumule type of area, that is said to be the colluptile. So these are the structure which distinguish the types of embryo present in the dicot and in the monocot type of stem. Depending upon the requirement or the development of the seeds, embryo are present. So today we have done three main type of fertilization, post-fertilization events. The post-fertilization event comprises of all those events which occurs after the fertilization. That is, usually what we have studied about, we have studied about the double fertilization. So here we are primarily discussed the consequences of the double fertilization. First we have done with the endosperm. What is the endosperm? What is the function of endosperm? Where the endosperm is present and which kind of endosperm divisions occur in various kinds of plants. Next, we have done the embryo. As you know, plants are usually of two types, monocotyledonous and the dicotyledonous type of seeds in the angiospermic plants. So in both, the structure and development of embryo is different. Thank you.